very pleased to serve as your master of ceremony, and I have a little help tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, from Elkhorn Electric, friends of the pantry, this is Ron Hornsby. Ron?
Good evening, everybody. I would like to take just a quick moment of your time, if I can. And I would like to say thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. For the generous donations of that peanut butter and jelly that you all brought in. And just so that you all know, that is one of the major staples of the pantry. They go through more than that than they do pasta. So, on behalf of the stress relievers who are out there in the audience, and also the pantry, welcome peanut butter and jelly. Give them a big hand.
And right now, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to welcome the one and the only Penny. Penny, join us on stage to a thunderous round of applause. Well, I have a little bit of housekeeping. First of all, the silent auction ends at 9 o'clock, so you can get your last signatures in and see if you can take home a little bit of fun. And I'll read this later. Penny?
Good evening. Welcome to the 6th annual Dancing with the Stars of Broward. We have a very exciting night, and we have a great group of judges, and we have a great group of dancers again this year. And I know we will entertain you. But before we move on to the dancers, I'd like to thank all the sponsors, and if all my board members would please stand up, Matthew Grant, Steve Daigle, Steve Adelstein, the board chair, E.J. Rosen, and anyone I forgot, Ron Ishoy. Without them, the pantry could not do as well as we do. So for their tireless efforts all year long, the pantry says thank you very, very much. And of course, we can't do it without our sponsors, our donors, and our volunteers. So I again say thank you to all of you. And if my staff would please stand up for their tireless efforts to put this show on. And of course, every gala needs a chair. And would Jen Clausen please join me on the stage?
Thank you so much, all of you all, for being here tonight. It's very special. We can't say thank you enough, the dedication of all the dancers coming here this evening. Given their time for the last 2 to 3 months, it's because of all of you. So thank you so much and enjoy yourself.
And I do want to tell you that she was one of our dancers one year, and she did really great. This is a token of our appreciation, because we love you.
Once again, a nice hand for Jen and for Penny. And let me explain what's going to happen tonight. We have a show for you. Our dancing couples have been preparing for this for months. They've been in rehearsal, they've been in costuming, and tonight is the night. They're nervously waiting backstage to perform for you, and tonight you have an important role. First of all, our dancers are going to be judged on a number of different things by our celebrity judges that you'll be meeting in just a few moments. They were our dancers from last year, and they're going to be judged on everything from chemistry to poise to costuming to crowd reaction. So let's have a little crowd reaction. One, two, three. Now that's what we're talking about. So the show's about to start, but right now we're going to have Ron come right back up to introduce us to our celebrity judges this evening.
All right, let's give a hand to our last year's dancers who are this year's judges. And just stand so everybody can see you. Alisa Lovett. Last year's runner-up, and she's representing Shooter's Waterfront. We appreciate that.
Say, you have a big, big part of tonight's show. By your reaction, you can also vote by giving generously. This is to benefit the Pantry of Broward. They do such wonderful work, and right now we're going to cast our eyes to the screens to show you the true meaning of what the pantry does. Please watch.
The pantry was created because I worked at another place, and the elderly were horribly mistreated, in my opinion. And we thought we could do a better job of taking care of these people. And we have.
Before I went to the pantry, the little money that was coming in from Social Security, that was all I used to pay the rent. So there was nothing for food.
At the time when I got involved with them, I needed help really desperately bad.
They helped me financially with getting food. They helped me with some clothing. For the school, a little guy for school.
I'll show you why you would want to get involved.
The Pantry of Broward is a nonprofit organization that deals with the elderly on low fixed incomes and grandparents raising grandchildren. A lot of people will come here because they heard that we give out food. And so we get them in the door. You must remember, these are very proud people. They've worked hard all their life. They never thought they'd be in this situation. Most of them have just outlived their money, and they're trying to make it on small pensions and Social Security. We explain to them the benefits of Medicaid and Medicare and food stamps and Social Security. A lot of these people don't know their entitlements. So not only do we inform them of their entitlements, we get them their entitlements. We give them a monthly food box, nutritious. We also have a clinical director that assesses each individual's needs, because food is just a symptom of the other things that they need. And then we proceed to fix their other issues. We do not send them to other places. We're not a referral ground. Whether it's they got behind on their light bill, or we have found an apartment to move them in, and they need some money for first, last, and security. If they need furniture in there. We have a lot of volunteers, and they come whatever day they choose, and they'll come in and stock our shelves with food that's been donated from churches, banks, schools, wherever. Every box gets peanut butter and jelly, so we always need peanut butter and jelly. 60% of our donors are grassroots. They're the most wonderful.
wife was a firm believer in random acts of kindness to people in need. And shortly after I lost her, I saw a TV program about the pantry, and a blue bell went off in my head. So the next day I called my niece and said, Janine, we're gonna buy some groceries and we're gonna make a delivery to a place in Fort Lauderdale. We went to the grocery store and bought everything we could that was buy one, get one free, and we drove down to the pantry. After that, I just started to spread the word to my people, and they started collecting food for me. Once I would get a batch of it, I'd call on a friend to drive me down there and drop it off.
We're now starting to get some grants, and we've gotten some sponsors, but we're still basically, our donors are grassroots, and we love each and every one.
And a nice hand for the Pantry of Broward. So ladies and gentlemen, that's why we're here tonight. So when you give, give generously. And may I also, before we begin, could we all give a thunderous round of applause to our presenting sponsor? They do such a great job in the community. It's the Seminole Hard Rock Hotel and Casino. To a whopping round of applause. And now, ladies and gentlemen, it's time for the fun. Feel free to whoop it up and holler and cheer for the dancers, because they have put in a lot of time. Let's meet couple number one.
Hi, I'm Sherry.
And I'm Tom.
As well as getting to know all about the charity and getting the word out. When they selected me to be with Dancing with the Stars of Broward, I was excited, also nervous, putting myself out there. But again, I had to remember it was all about the charity and doing what was best.
When Sherry first came to me, she was probably the most advanced dancer that I've ever worked with throughout the 6 years of Dancing with the Stars. She came with a dance background.
Wow, 30 years ago, and it was ballet, so it's not ballroom.
It's a. Ah, that was it. So the high kick, do it like that.
Awesome, all right.
Super good.
Let's do it again.
Definitely out of the box.
absolutely loved it. What a great way to start the evening. Thank you guys, it's been great.
Last year's heard Kathy O'Brien. Kathy.
Hot, hot, hot. Which I know we've heard that before. It was so creative, energetic, and so.
Kathy left. Perfect. It reminds me of like checks all the boxes on my checklist and reminds me of my generation, the 80s, the Legends, Jennifer Beatles. What could be better?
And last but not least, Lee Blakely, tell us what you think.
Wow, Sherry, you got some moves, chica.
Well, I must say, judges, I think you got it right. A nice hand for couple number one, Pablo and Sherry. And the judges do have a very difficult job. There's a number of criteria that they're going to be judging. It'll go back to our canning room in the back. And right now, it's time for couple number two. Once again, let's meet them on the screen. Couple number two.
Hi, I'm Axel.
I'm Chelsea.
And we're Dazzle in the Stars. I'm Flowers. My favorite experience with Dazzle in the Star is dancing with the stars. It's been fun to put it all, however everything was about. The architect here, the mad genius, mad scientist, she goes away an idea and then just see it from the beginning to the end. I'm a little impatient, so we'll find see a final product is gratifying.
I would say he has come in and taught me moves that I don't know. So he's actually teaching me and I'm teaching him. So it's a good learning experience.
I think I made some leaps. There's a couple of moves that I didn't quite get at the beginning. And we're just having a hard time with it, so we either tweak them or did some down and just kind of feel the music and just, you know, get with it. It's been definitely a humbling experience and gratifying being able to be part of this event and help out the pantry and those in need and just be a part of it. Team us!
From Bottle Nation, it's Axel and Chelsea!
I love you. I think you're so demonic.
actions in your life, and you could not have been paired with a better person than Chelsea. She is an amazing instructor, an amazing dancer, and the two of you pulled it off perfectly. Thank you so much.
And thank you, Lee. And this time we'll go to Kathy next. Kathy?
Yes. I loved it. Anyone that can do anything like that that I can, I love it. And Chelsea, you know I love you. You're energetic. And Axel, you got a perfect partner. I loved it. I thought it was great.
Very well put. Alisa?
All I can say is, you have some moves. Shake that money maker.
John, what are your thoughts?
I'm going to pick up where I left off. I'm from the 80s, but this was good. It's like another century, but they really got it down. I worked with Axel. I did not know he could move like that. I used to see him on a cubicle coding. He does this very well, too.
Nice of them, John. And last but not least, just a little more to Luke.
Loved it. I tell you, I'm a little jealous. I got to dance with Chelsea last year. But you did a great job. Some of those moves were awesome. So, congratulations.
Excellent, Chelsea. Couple number two. And right now it's time to move on to couple number three. Once again, let's look to the screens. Let's meet our third couple for the night.
We're golfed, we work off each other, we have good energy, changed things around. Beats.
Spiritual beats. That's why we're on the
scene. My red.
There you go.
Ladies and gentlemen, here they are, couple number three, Vance and Kathy.
Go, Vance!
in the middle and start with Kathy O'Brien. Kathy.
That was very entertaining. Vance, I love you. I never know what's coming out of your brain.
And we'll go right down the line to Mr. John Mabry. John.
I didn't know what the story was, but I think it was very creative, so I'll wait for the movie or the video to figure out what the story is. But it was really good. And then the band, so I remember from last year. We don't know what's happening, but it's good. And Lee?
Well, as you know, Vance was my partner last year. I'm glad that you could take time out of your busy acting schedule to join us again. Congratulations on your career. Kathleen, I must say one thing. You're a stronger woman than I am because last year Vance says, I'm going to flip you, Lee. And I said, no, you're not. And of course, he did. So I don't know how you got beyond that, because it's a signature move. Very creative. Vance is known for doing very, very creative choreography. We appreciated it very much. I hope you enjoyed it, Kathleen. We certainly did. Thank you.
Alisa.
I have to say, man, you're so out of the box as always. It was very mystical and entertaining, outrageous, very different, but it was incredible.
Very nice. And last but not least, of course, Mr. Luke.
Vance, you were okay. Amazing. You really.
The folks in the orange hats, of course, they are from. And now we're going to meet our fifth and final couple for Dancing with the Stars in round number one. Ladies and gentlemen, couple number four, my mistake. Let's meet them right now.
I'm Henry.
And I'm Rachel.
And we're Dancing with the Stars.
Very gorgeous.
Oh, wait a minute, Wendy. Yeah, I can't. I'm sorry. It's been
a great experience so far for a great charity. And we're really enjoying it, with Rachel teaching me all the fancy moves as a dancer should know, but I don't, because I'm not really a dancer to the ballroom type dancing. I know I can do this, I know I can do this, I know I can do this, but I know I just can't really do the art of dancing. I like the way you move, though. I can't move in that.
I like the way you move.
You can't, but how do I move?
Is there anybody from Hard Rock in the house? Ladies and gentlemen, Rachel and Henry Franzello!
You can dance every dance with the guy who gives you the eye. Yeah.
Let's go back in time to the old happy feelings. Let's start another.
inspector who's going to come out, DJ Board Chair of the Pantry of Brown, to a big round of applause.
Good evening, everybody. My name is EJ. I'm Board Chair. Every year, my husband writes a speech for me to give to all of you. And, you know, he gets paid to talk. He's a trial attorney. And every year, you know what happens? Cocktail hour. And I throw the speech out. But this year, I promised him I would give it. My husband and I became affiliated with the Pantry of Broward 6 years ago. We read an article in the paper about seniors who have outlived their income and grandparents raising grandchildren. And we had just become grandparents, so it really hit home with us. We love it, and we've been involved ever since. And I hope all of you will be, too. I'd like to thank my fellow board members, Matt, Steve, Ron, Paul, and Steve. You are my board playmates, and I know how hard you work, and I appreciate everything you do, just for being there for me and for the pantry. I would like to thank our staff, Terrence and Michael and Lydia and Betty and the whole crew, because you know what? They work with Penny, who I have to tell you is a slave driver. And she does this because she loves the pantry and she wants to find a lot of success for our clients. I particularly want to thank our volunteers. Without none of this can happen. So with that, I leave you. Please, thank you for coming. Thank you for supporting us. Please give generously to all of the dancers that you love, and let's dance.
And right now we're gonna have a word from Penny, who has a little surprise. Penny?
Okay, I tried to do something for 2 years. I finally decided I would just do it, and I thought about it real long and hard to try to come up with a way to raise money that wouldn't hurt anybody. So, with your help in this room, my goal is to raise $8,000, $1 at a time. All you need to do, and I'm going to show you how easy it is, and for those of you who are computer challenged like I am, the person sitting next to you will know how to do this. Okay. I put together, with the help of Lydia and Don and Russell and David, a YouTube video. The challenge is not only do you have to go online and donate $1, but you must get 20 of your friends to go online, look at the YouTube, and donate $1. It won't hurt anybody, and within 3 days, we will have raised $8,000 because of all of you in this room. On your table, you have these little cards, and on the back of the little card, it's called something, and I already forgot.
QR code!
Right, it's called that. And all you have to do is scan it on your phone, and then push the magic button, and you will have donated $1. And then you have to get 20 of your friends and the 400 people in this room, we will have raised $8,000. And now, without further ado, please, I hope you like my YouTube. Here it is.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5,
I made this video too.
Don't give up, it's never too late. You feel it down. Your life is full of doubt, and you can use a helping hand. The Pantry of Brown would understand. Reach out and catch yourself.
California,
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 Ladies and gentlemen, the Sunrise Serenaders! Big round of applause, Sunrise Serenaders! And ladies and gentlemen, round number two is coming up. We'd like to remind you that the guitar centerpieces was graciously donated by the Seminole Hard Rock Hotel Casino. They're going up for auction. The starting bid is $100, so you can take one home with you tonight. And right now, we're going to ask you all to the dance floor. And
booty! Woo! Go, Don!
from Seminole Hard Rock. Are you having some fun? And from Best Roofing. They started drinking around 2 o'clock this afternoon, I'm sure. All the country clubs are represented here today. We've got Auto Nation is here. And ladies and gentlemen, it's time for round number 2. We have a very, very tight competition. And once again, our judges are on the line, and we're going to have one more opportunity for you to vote by giving generously. You did very well the first round. We want to do even more for the second round. Let's welcome back to the stage couple number 1. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome Pablo and Sherry.
It was very good. I absolutely found it the best moments.
Thank you. I don't know, John. Who do you think? Paulo, you're an amazing dancer, an amazing instructor, and Sherry, you obviously have taken so well to his guidance and his mentoring, because I'm telling you, Chico, I'm like sweating watching you do that dance. Congratulations.
Well, we've heard from the judges. Nice hand for Sherry and Paulo. What a way to kick off round number two. And right now, it's time for us to have another look at couple number two, Chelsea and Axel.
They can't slip, dude.
Take his shirt.
Woo!
Mr. John.
I don't know if it's the line or what, I'm just gonna say it. I did like a Latin number last year. Didn't look anything as good as this. I didn't lose any weight, but it was like spot on. It was very, very entertaining, energetic. I can tell you guys like each other. So I don't know, right back with tens all the way down the sheet. I absolutely loved it. I wish I could move on.
And there is a big round of applause for couple number two, Axel and Chelsea. Once again, we have Kathleen and Vance. Last year's winner, of course, Kathy O'Brien. Kathy?
I have to
songs, and it's happy. And I was really hoping that someone would dance to that tonight, because it takes a lot of energy to do that. And it was really, really good. I enjoyed it. You guys were great. Kathleen, you were great.
And give it up for Dancing Kathleen. And now we move on to our next couple. And of course we have the poker table, and the dealer is taking his place. That must mean one thing. Yay! It's Rachel and Henry. Rachel and Henry. My poker thing. We'll be right back. I think they went out cocktailing. I can't be sure, but I think so. I think we need to have a huge round of applause for all of our dancers. After weeks and weeks of training, they came and danced their heart out, and I must tell you that tonight we had an unprecedented moment of generosity because you all have exceeded all expectations. We've raised so much money for the Panther crowd, and we've had a great time in doing it. But right now, we're going to ask the lovely Jenna Carlson to bring you the envelope. We have the two top finishers that are going to have a dance-off. We're going to collect the money one more time, and we're going to have Jen actually tell us who our finalists are. Pound your tables, drum roll, ladies and gentlemen, drum roll on your tables. Here are our finalists for this, the 6th annual Dancing with the Stars of Howard, Jen. Our two finalists to dance one more dance, and then we're going to go around the room one more time, and you can get all your extra tickets and dig deep in your pockets. Because they are just giving money away in the casino tonight. Here's our second finalist, ladies and gentlemen, it's Rachel and Henry. Bye, bye, bye.
Look at those boogie shoes!
I wanna put on.
And with that, my friends, we're going to ask all of our dancers this year to come onto the stage. All of our dancers, our professional dancers, and our stars, please make your way.
I appreciate you. Good job. Good job.
I see how hard everyone's worked tonight, and I know how hard it is as a dancer, and I wish the final two contestants the best of luck, and everybody's here tonight is a winner, because no matter what, the money, all that is raised here tonight goes to the pantry of ours, so thank you everyone for all that you've done.
Amen, sister.
Congratulations to all the dancers. You guys did a great job. Thanks for all the hard work. Congratulations, man. Thank you for another great year of service to the community. Thank you.
And Kathy.
What am I going to say? This is such a wonderful year. All the dancers are just. Exceptional, wonderful, and I enjoyed coming to dance again with Pablo, my baby. And it was wonderful. I love everyone, and thank you so much for coming out and supporting the pantry. That is the most important part of this whole
thing. Nice.
Hey.
Does this not work?
No.
There
you go.
Okay, so. I agree on my fellow compatriot. I don't know. I'm just wrong. What I just want to say is being a judge is much easier than being a dancer. And if you need a permanent judge, I'm available. That's all I got to say.
Oh my goodness. I'm not drunk because I drink wine for a living. So if anybody's interested in that, you can call. Anyway, again, I want to just echo what the other judges have said tonight.
Linda.
No matter who the final winner is in tonight's competition, thank all five of the couples for dancing, but really the true winner here is the pantry of Brown. Tremendous amount of work on this event, as have all of the staff of the dancers, a special shout to Terry, and also Six Star Entertainment. They're the company that we use to make this beautiful event happen. Thank you very much. Thank you, Hard Rock, for being the venue to make a beautiful event tonight.
Preach.
The last thing I want to say to all the dancers, and please, pay attention for a moment. All of you dancers, you're going to be judges next year. I hope that you are fortunate enough to make friendships like the five of us have done.
No!
And you carry that forward in your life beyond tonight's competition, beyond next year's judging, because really the friendships are part of the greatest results of the evening. So thank you all very much.
Well said.
And thanks to all of our judges and here's some people. John, you can come back next year and lead to the wines for humanity. Supply the wine, because we want John back next year. Every cocktail, man, it's all about, and you're right, Lee, it's all about the friendships. And let me just say, you've been all very good friends this year. We're going to have Jay come up one more time because we have a huge announcement. You've been very, very generous, Jay. Come up into the total. What we made tonight with the online pre-voting and also what you put in the buckets tonight, this is how much you all did in this room tonight. Read that number, Jim.
$58,458.90.
Give yourselves a huge round of applause. And if you dancers are all The Dance with the Stars folk. Ron, please come back up. A nice hand for our co-host tonight, Ron. He gets the honor.
Thank you very much.
Who is the winner tonight? Can I just say it was a very tight competition, a lot of money in, a lot of great dancing. And won't you please announce who our celebrity winner is tonight?
The winner tonight is Harry.
Let's